Hello, my name is Dmytro Lukyanov, and I'd like to show you a demo about API Manager from WSO2 company. The sources of this demo published at Elix Integration Platform repository on GitHub. And I'm going to run it on AWS Cloud. As you can see, I have nothing over there except just one default security group. And in 10 minutes, I'm going to have the following infrastructure over there. Kubernetes cluster with master and two workers, API manager and analytics running, application load balancer to provide access to our applications, Bastion host to manage Kubernetes, and random host name from AWS. You could follow the instructions below to reproduce all the steps from this demo. And let's start. I already have integration platform repository on my computer, and I am inside Terraform AWS folder. And with help of Terraform, I'm going to create an infrastructure. Just three commands. Create new workspace. Initialize the project and apply. Create the infrastructure. While it's running, let's see the details of API Manager. API Manager is one of the key components of the modern service and microservice architectures. This one consists of the several parts. Publisher, it's a portal for API developers. You could design API here, document it, prototype, and publish finally. Actually, you could control the full life cycle of the APIs. Developer portal is for application developers that are going to consume APIs. Gateways and micro gateways, you could have multiple of them, provide access to the back-end services. Key manager to authenticate and authorize, traffic manager to control the traffic, and analytical tools to collect statistics about API calls. And let's wait for the end of Terraform and then continue with API Manager in details. And it's done. First of all, let's check the AWS console. We see four running instances. And as expected, master to workers and Bastion host. Bastion host has public API address and you can use it to access it through SSH. Now let's go to Kubernetes dashboard. It requests token. Everything is green, so I am happy. And the API Manager. Admin. And it's running. We are inside API Manager. There is a first service pre-deployed during installation. And I'm going to create a new from scratch. Design new API, start creating. Second, context, part of URL. Second, version 1.00. And let's define one endpoint. Countries by code. Will be get. If you need to, you could edit service definition by using Swagger editor. Let me paste the complex service definition and we will see how it looks like. Instantly on the right, you could see the documentation for the service. So by editing on the left, you will see the information on the right. Let's apply changes and go to the implementation. I'd like to create a prototype first of all. Inline, get. It already suggests me JavaScript code to prototype the service. There is a code parameter that is coming through URL, and let's define the response. Again, I'm going to paste it from prepared. It's just a JSON, as you can see. And let me make it a little more dynamic. Let's use this parameter code in the response. For example, ID will be the code, and Isaac code the same, and for the name we will have something like name for plus code. Deploy and publish. Let's go to API Store. API Store, it's a portal for developers of applications. Here we see our service, second, version 1, status prototyped. And from API console, we could try it. Country code, execute. And we see the response, name for ZZZ. Great. Let's imagine that we have implemented the service on the backend. So I'm going to edit the API and provide the endpoint in the implementation, managed API. I'm going to specify the URL of the backend service. Next. On the Manage tab, I have to define subscription tier. And that's all. That's enough to save and publish. Let's go again to API Store. Refresh. Now the status is published. And to be able to call the published service, we have to subscribe to it. So let's go to applications. At this point, we have to sign in. Let's close the wizard. Again, applications. There is default application generated by API Manager. You could create a multiple of them. And right now there is no subscriptions. Let's go to APIs and subscribe to our second service. Subscribe. Great. Let's generate a key to access the service. By the way, here you can see the secure protocols that supported by API Manager. Let's go and call the API. Console. Let's specify something UA for Ukraine. And we see the response Ukraine. This one is correct response, but XML. And we would like to see JSON. Let's go again and edit our API. On the implementation tab, we could define the message mediation. It's mediation that you could apply for input flow message, output flow message, or fault flow. There are some predefines, like XML to JSON out message. Or you could upload your own. For fault flow, I'd like to see also JSON. Next. And publish. Store, and let's call it again. And voila, we see here JSON in response. Let's try some other country. United States. And let's try some non-existing country. Fault message. Parameter country has invalid value. Super. Now let's go and publish the first service. APIs. First. We couldn't see it in the store because it's in status created and not published yet. Publish. Success. And now let's go to APIs in the store. Try to call it. First of all, I have to subscribe. Stay on this page. And let's go to API console. This is absolutely the same service, but automatically deployed. Try Great Britain. And we have correct response. Let's call it for something else. Friends. I guess it's for friends. Yeah, friends. And now let's look at analytics. API, API usage. We see the service second, the first one, total hits two. There are different views for the service usage. I like this one with latency. There is a total time response, backend response time, and latency that was lost for authentication, 8 milliseconds. And we have two portals for administrators. First one, admin, to approve or reject different tasks, like user creation, application creation, subscription for the services, registration, and so on. Also, you could manage different settings, micro gateways, throttling policies, and manage some administration alerts for anomalies, like response time, backend response time, request counts. Just specify your email. And if API Manager configured with email server parameters, it will work. And the last admin console, named Carbon. It's a standard one for WSO2 products. You could manage users, user stores over there. For example, you could connect Active Directory or LDAP server or specify external database. Also, you could deploy some standard Java web applications. And let me summarize. API Manager from WSO2, it's fully open source product. You could manage an API lifecycle through it, from design and documentation to prototyping and deployment to production. It supports all modern security protocols, multiple gateways, caching, throttling, message transformation, and other features. It could be deployed at any cloud or on personal computer. It's also applicable to multi-cloud or hybrid cloud infrastructures. And finally, API Manager is a good point to start changes to enterprise architecture. Digitize business and then automate it. Thank you for watching. Have a fun. Bye.